good morning. I just woke up. I'm not even gonna lie to you.
Do you see these bags? They're a designer.
Today's gonna be a fun day. Feel it. I can feel it in my bone. Today I'm making a secret compartment book. And if you guys don't know what that is, well, you're gonna find out today. So kind of calm down, relax. I do wanna show you something. And I can't make this up. This is so ridiculous. So basically, my building has been having issues with people flushing kitty litter down the toilet, kitchen grease down the toilet. Somebody even tried to flush a pair of jeans, and that clogged our septic tank system. Some dumbass decided to try to flush jeans. I didn't even know you could even do that. Kudos to them for getting like that far in the game. So because of all this, we've got this new building manager who, in my opinion, is, oh my god, she's so aggressive with whatever she sent out. We get email, when you live in a building, by the way, you're a part of this email list. I get sent out to everybody. So when there's an issue, they send it out to everybody. What I've learned from moving into like my own place is that people don't get more mature as they get older. People are still dropping soda cans off of a really tall building. And needless to say, they're flushing jeans down the toilet. Like, what the f-? So to address this issue, my building management decided to say this. It's like a very loose threat. Management will be monitoring very closely all units that have cats and those that are suspected of pouring grease down their kitchen sinks. How the hell are you gonna suspect somebody pouring kitchen grease down the sink?
Yeah, they do. They totally pour kitchen grease down their sink.
Oh, this is so stupid. DNA sampling of cat litter in the pipes will be done to identify the cat and responsible culprit. They're gonna pull some CSI on these cats just to figure out who's doing it. It's so stupid. Anyways, guys, let's get to it. Today's agenda is I'm gonna head to like a Value Village or like a Goodwill to buy like a big old book. Let's go. Oh, shit. I was gonna walk like into the camera, which there's a huge window and a drop down there, so I couldn't do that, so I gotta walk. I'll go this way. Okay guys, so the type of book that I'm looking for is, it's not that it could technically be any book, it can't. It's gotta be a pretty thick book. In fact, whatever you're trying to keep secret inside of this book, the pages have to be thicker than that. Okay, got the book, so I went with, I didn't go for a specific like story plot, I didn't really give a shit. So I'm going with this one because it's that thick. I wanna hide like watches or rings. This one works perfect. Plus, I can take off this paper cover and it's like a, looks like a, just a standard ass book. This is gonna do, Peggy. Let's do it. Okay, so we got our book. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna remove this paper cover because I don't need it. And I think it looks better and more secretive like this. We got all the pages, they're all there. You guys wanna make sure that you grab Mod Podge, but make sure that it's matte finish because if it's a gloss finish, then the pages, once the glue is dried, will look shiny, which will then look also fake. We're gonna coat the outside so the pages are now stuck together. Okay, so now we're gonna coat these pages with glue. So Mod Podge is essentially just glue. Now you don't have to necessarily squeeze the book really tight here because it wouldn't be a bad thing if glue seeped through some of the pages. So I'm used to curling hundreds, so I do have a couple of tens lying around. We're just gonna place those on top. And we're gonna let that sit for about 15 to 20 minutes and come back. Okay, so it's been about 20 minutes. Only the top should open, see? So it's like, it's glued shut, like. And what's great about this Mod Podge, which again, you have to make sure you get matte, is that this looks like just like a closed book. Okay, so step two. We are now going to cut out a square as to where we want our safe to be. Keep in mind, guys, you don't want to make the walls too thin, otherwise they'll kind of cave in. First couple pages should come out. Because we've scored them, these pages should just kind of like rip on out, just like this. Once it starts to get difficult for these pages to come out, you're gonna score the lines again. You want to push hard too, just watch your fingers. The next couple pages. So as you guys can already start to see, it's starting to create a little pocket that you could hide stuff in already. Okay. Okay, so now that we got the inside cut out and as clean as like we're probably gonna get it, the outside is still glued. It has come undone a little bit here, so we're gonna do another coat on the outside, but at the same time we're gonna coat the inside with Mod Podge as well. Okay, the inside is done. We're gonna let that dry before we close it up and do the outside again. All right, the inside's now dry. Now we're gonna do the outside. Okay, so the glue has dried on both the outside here and on the inside as well. So these walls are now pretty sturdy of the book. If you look at the book, it looks like a standard book. Okay, you open it up. Ooh, the secret. We'll put a ring in there, put another ring in there, put a gold watch in there, crystal elephant I have, another gold necklace, 3 years of nudes. Let's go ahead and close that up and boom. Okay, so the book is done. That was like a little Sunday crap that I wanted to do. I've always wanted one of these secret books. And guys, if you have like candy or you have like other things that you want to hide, this is a great way to do it because it is super secretive. Just looks like a book chilling on my shelf, but when you open it up, it holds all my jewelry. The next thing where people go wrong is they have like one ghetto ass book on their shelf and the rest are like normal books. If you're trying to hide stuff, make sure you've got more than just the one. I just go ahead and just put the book in there. Again, probably not the best one, I realize that, but like just for the sake of this video, put it like where books are. I can do that book right there and nobody's interested because, well,
it's a book.
Boom, there you guys have it. That is how you make one of those secret book safes. It is easy, just make sure you get matte Mod Podge. Don't worry necessarily about cleaning up the insides very well because this is supposed to be something that only you see, so unless it bothers you, don't worry about it. But yeah, that was a little DIY. If you guys want some more this week, because I've said in the past I'm gonna start doing videos more frequently, if you guys want more DIYs like this, let me know and I'll do some this week for sure. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't, guys. If you guys do end up doing this, please post a photo on Instagram or Twitter. I'd love to see it. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. See you guys later. Oh, and by the way, happy Thanksgiving to all the Canadians out there. Okay, see ya.